Social accountability is really the main fiber of our faculties of medicine in Canada.
Social accountability in Canadian medical schools reflects the diversity of the country itself.
Medical schools will meet the priority health concerns of the communities they serve, and the concerns are determined with community.
Being engaged with the community people, serving them, not doing community work in the community, but doing medical services with the people and for the people and through the people. That to us is social accountability.
The idea behind it is really finding new ways of measuring success. How do you see success? Very often we judge our schools by grants, the research they're conducting, publications, and other ways, whereas we need to really focus on what value they're bringing to the society and how they respond to it, how connected they are to changing communities, changing situations.
Social accountability is so important to our faculties that, in fact, our deans of medicine across the country agreed to have a social accountability mission as mandated by accreditation that had to be accounted for not only from the point of view of admissions requirements, curriculum, location of clinical experiences, assessment, the outcomes from their graduates. It really, to me, is the epitome of what our commitment to social accountability is in our Canadian medical schools.
From the point of view of the relationship, I perseverate on the idea of the pentagram partners, because if the policymakers are part of that, and they have to be, then they need to be in the room. The managers who actually have to animate that policy and apply that policy, they need to be in the room. The professionals who are in the day-to-day interaction, not only with individual patients, but collectively across professions with the communities in which they're embedded to identify what the needs in that particular community at that particular time are, need to be in the room. The academy, in its best expression, needs to be one of the five. And most importantly, the fifth member of the pentagram, which all the other four partners claim to speak for, but need to listen to, is the community or the patients or a voice from that perspective.
And so I think that this will ultimately start the important discussion about what is community and who represents what communities means a fundamental change in how they see themselves and how they do their work.
We need much more diversity and more voices in there, and actually a co-ownership, if you will. Communities need to be a part of what we do, and they hold us accountable, and they put a mirror to our face and help us see whether we are making the kind of difference that we want.
How does the academic community contribute to positive health system change? If we take that as the lens and we say, what are good examples of that? Well, we have some very obvious ones, like the Northern Ontario School of Medicine, which embedded those partners, embedded those processes, embedded those values with a strong connection, not only with the Anglophone community in Northern Ontario, but also the Francophone community and the Aboriginal community.
There are some initiatives, for instance, of expanding Indigenous health in the curriculum, something that hasn't really been embraced until very recently by most, by changing some of their admissions processes to be more open to students from backgrounds that have been excluded in the past from medical schools. So those would be some of the initial pieces that will help make the change.
For a place like the Philippines, society means it is composed of people, majority of whom are poor and needing a lot of help and assistance. So whenever we train our students in a Jesuit university like the Ateneo de Zamboanga, we want them to be giving attention precisely to this society, to these people, in terms of service, in terms of social responsibility.
Our students had to do a survey with the community people, and from there drew out the problems of the community. And then from there, we challenge them to be involved, how to solve this problem. So our students were actually just serving as catalysts there. But the main driver, the main people who are really actually solving the problems are the community themselves, drawing from their own resources. But what the students in addition did was to connect them with other existing network. And part of which is, of course, there are existing programs of the government which are untapped because the community people doesn't even know about them. So the students kind of serve as the bridge. And that's what we call bridging leadership, connecting the people with other networks so that the problems can be solved. At the time when we started the medical school, the byword social accountability was not yet well known or being used. But I think we were already doing it.
How we do things will have to change, and it will look differently. And I think most people head into these things thinking, well, we'll just tweak here a little bit and do a little bit there and we'll bring a community member there. But everything's going to feel kind of the same. And I think that that's the fundamental difficulty with implementing real social accountability.
And that is our vision, that the students and community have some sort of a mutual relationship of learning and helping each other.